Hello, this is Ankit Reddy. Welcome to the .NET course from Educators.com, world's best online training tutorial for the leading technologies. In this video, we'll discuss on .NET course for the C# .NET interfaces. We create interfaces using interface keyword. Just like classes, interfaces also contain fields and methods inside in it, but only declarations, but no implementation. Only declaration, but doesn't have any implementation. It's a compile time error to provide implementation for any interface members. Interfaces cannot contain fields. Let us flip to Visual Studio and let us see that in detail. I told that how we create classes with the keyword class, we create same like interfaces with the keyword interface. Create a class, then I will show you that how to create interface. How to create a class? Class, then customer. We'll be creating like this. In the same way, how to create an interface? By taking interface keyword, we'll be creating an interface. Here, just like classes, interface also contain fields, but methods inside in it, but only declarations of methods. There is no implementation. If you want to create an interface, we'll prefix with the capital letter I before that. I customer now. Interface I customer. But this is a naming convention, not a mandatory. Don't worry about that. Why we will give that I as is? The reason behind that is, we'll be giving that is, by looking at the name, we'll come to know that it is an interface. Wherever you are using interface, you usually identify with that name itself. So not only here, if you wanted to use or if you wanted to watch other developers code, you can easily identify what is this. By looking at the name itself, you can find out this is an interface. As I told that interfaces contain only declarations but not implementations. If you write the code, let us see. Let me write a code, then show you that. Print me. Yeah, like this console dot print out hello, save it, build it. Cannot be contain a definition. Interface members cannot have a definition. Understand? Interface members cannot have a definition. They need to have only declarations. Let us change the code. Another important thing is interface members are public by default. We cannot have an explicit modifier including, let me change this. I told right, we cannot have a definition like this. So we should keep like this. Let me build this. Build is accident. Suppose if we try to do like this, build it is not valid for this item because interface members are by default public. You cannot have again one more access modifier. Understand? Another important thing is interface doesn't contain fields. Like we declare integer, string in classes. If we do so, integer ID in the interface, what will happen? Let us see. I will show you that. Integer ID. Now let me build this. Interface cannot contain fields. Understand? A class can inherit an interface. Let me remove this. A class can inherit interface. I customer. Now let us build this again. Does not implement interface member print me because here is a method is there. We need to implement as well as if a class inherit an interface, then that class should provide implementation for that interface members. This is the interface member. A member or a method, both are same. Whenever I pronounce member or a method, please treat it as both are same. If you compile without interface members implementation in the derived class, we are getting error message. Does not implement interface member I customer dot print me. Here you can read this in the last line. I customer dot print me. Interface members are there to be implemented in the derived class only. So we should provide implementation for the members which are there in the interface. We might be wondering that if the interface doesn't provide any implementation, then what is the use of these interfaces? This we will talk later. As of now, we'll see. As of now, we'll discuss about what interface is and what are the basic rules around it. Let us see how to implement the interface members in the derived class. We have printme method in the iCustomer. Now I am going to implement that. Public void printme. Now you can have this console.writeline. Let us see what will happen. Build is succeeded. Again, the interface member printme and the derived class implemented printme. Let me have this. I'm going to take integer ID and build this. Does not implement interface member printme. See this. Though it is the same name, but as it is contained another variable inside it, it is throwing error saying again, it is a not implemented this method because signature should be same in interface member and derived class implemented member. Remove the signature ID and let us see this. Now you won't get any error. Will get succeeded. So though the name is same, but all the things signatures also should be matched with the members which are there in this interface. Let us see some more. Build is successful. Now we'll improve the code and run again. What I'm going to do, take is instead of disturbing this main program, let me take this out here. Let me take a class customer, then let me inherit this in this. In this class, let me take this printme method. Let me change this interface printme method. Now I'm going to create an object for this class inside a main program. Obj is equal to new customer. Obj dot printme method is called. So let's see this. It's a compile time error to provide implementation for an interface member. Interface cannot contain fields. If a class inherits from an interface, it must provide implementation for all interface members. Otherwise, you get a compile time error. A class can inherit from more than one interface at the same time, but whereas a class cannot inherit from more than one class at the same time. Let us see that some more. A class can inherit from more than one interface, I said, right? Let's see that practically. We have a class. Before that, we have an interface iCustomer. In that, we have a method, printme method. Let me take one more interface. Let me name it as i2. Then, instead of this method, let me take i2 printme method. Then inside a class, a class can inherit more than one interface. See here, this is legally correct. And what you need to do, just build this, you can come to know that what is the error. You need to provide i2 printme method also implementation because it is not implemented here. So let me take this and copy. Now let me take this i2 printme. This can write it. Now this is valid now. There will be no errors. What I am telling is a class can inherit from more than one interfaces at the same time. This is one of the interesting and important concepts of interfaces. We cannot inherit a class from more than one class at a time. See here, we are inheriting from more than one interface. But if you have a class, let me take class A. is there, then let me take class B. Then let me take one more class. Now see, this is very much important. A class C can inherit from another class. Fine. If I wanted to inherit one more class, see this, it is color not changed. Suppose if you build this, we'll be getting error here. Cannot have multiple base classes. So which is not permitted in the C#.NET. We cannot inherit more than one class. We cannot inherit a class from more than one class at a time. We have seen, right? This will be throwing compile time error as class cannot have multiple base classes. You can see here. Cannot have multiple base classes. So interfaces can inherit from other interfaces. A class that inherits this interface must provide implementation. Suppose we have, let me delete this, or else let me comment this. We have interface iCustomer, then interface can inherit other interface again, suppose like this. So if anybody is inheriting this I2, then everyone should provide implementation for all the methods, this method and this method here. Then only it will allow you. As we are implemented already, suppose I am implementing only I2, inheriting I2 only. If you don't implement this method, you will get error. Because this I2 is inherited from again customer I customer. And if you provide only iPrintMe method also, if you ignore this method giving implementation, still you will be getting error. Does not implement interface member. So whatever there in the chain, you should provide implementation for all the methods. Otherwise, you will be getting this kind of error message. So we need to provide implementation of all the interfaces in that chain. So we cannot create an instance of interface, but an interface reference variable can point to the derived class object. Suppose, let me tell you nothing. Build it. We're getting still error. Yeah, it's fine. Customer object, we have created object. Now before we want to finish this, I2 print me. We cannot create an instance of an interface. Understand? Suppose, let me create an instance here. Which is equal to, we're not getting this. Cannot create an instance of an interface. But we can do here like customer. If I do like this, we'll be getting I2 print me and print me methods again. Whatever one, you can get it. So here we are doing uppercast it is. So customer class, we are assigning to iCustomer interface, because this is already have features of this one via inheritance. So we can uppercast like this. Either you can create an object for class itself, or by taking interface and assign this customer class to this one, then we can get this I2 print me and print me methods. Hope you understand this interface. Let me read this. We create interface using interface keyword. Just like classes, interface also contain fields and methods inside in it, but only declarations are methods, no implementations. It's a compile time error to provide implementation for an interface member. Interfaces cannot contain fields. If a class inherits from an interface, it must provide implementation for all the interface members. Otherwise, we get a compile time error. A class can inherit from more than one interface at the same time, but whereas a class cannot inherit from more than one class at the same time. We have seen here. This is not possible in C#. This is one of the important interview question. They will write this one and they will ask, is this possible or not? Tell them that it is not at all possible. It is possible with the interfaces. Suppose if I change here interface A, let me take here interface B, then it is possible. See, no errors is coming. A class can inherit more than one interfaces, but a class cannot inherit more than one class. Thank you for watching. In the next video session, we'll be discussing very important interview question, that is called what is the difference between abstract class and interface.